You know, we've seen, as you mentioned, a lot of different proposals, and to kind of follow on what Evelyn said, and not to make too much of a pun, I don't want to monopolize the conversation by going into too much detail on them, but there are two kind of major legislative packages, so to speak, that are currently getting attention. The first is a group of bills in the U.S. House of Representatives that went through a markup earlier this year. There are many different bills in this package that range from things that would update the filing fees related to mergers to things that are much more interventionary and would be significant changes from the current approach to antitrust enforcement. Right now, antitrust enforcement is largely based on a consumer welfare standard. Most of these proposals are looking more towards that European standard that was mentioned earlier, more towards things like the Digital Markets Act that would instead shift a focus to a presumption of wrongdoing for these largest companies, particularly when it comes to things like mergers and acquisitions, where there would be a shift in the burden and a shift in the presumption of what mergers would be allowed to go forward, as well as to things such as the ability to package products and services together, or the ability to even have generic brands on things like Amazon Prime or Apple's own apps in its app store. Those are what's going on in the House side. And most notably for this panel, there is a bill in that package that is very data portability focused. And I'm sure later on in this panel, we can get into some of the privacy concerns that can come from portability mandates when we're looking at the national security front. Then on the Senate side, you have Amy Klobuchar and led bill that again is looking at big tech specifically, but could have much broader implications in the future potentially. And again, is shifting more back to that big is bad concern. It too has some of these portability mandated elements in it. It's not as far as the separate bill in the House, which is the Access Act, but I think it's important to draw attention to these concerns, particularly when we are talking about national security, for what this could mean in terms of some of our global leaders having to potentially go away from what consumers want, which is a desire for more privacy, to instead having to hand over data to other players, not only competitors in the US, but potentially foreign adversaries in some cases where they may have severe questions about what they're going to do with that data if it is handed over. I will also say, when we're looking at this more generally, when it comes to antitrust in the US and this potential shift to a more European model, we also have to consider that this really is a global market, that these companies are competing with international rivals. And so as we're having these debates, one of the debates that keeps coming up time and time again, both in terms of what is the market definition regarding the service, but also what is the market definition in terms of, given the current geopolitical and global landscape, how are these companies competing not only with each other domestically, but with perhaps Chinese and Russian counterparts?